Namaste students, welcome back to my channel. Students, we have studied various gas laws. Now, in 1857, there was a scientist Clausius. In 1857, to explain the general properties of the gases and the gas laws theoretically, Clausius put forward a theory which is known as काइनेटिक मॉलिकुलर थ्योरी ऑफ गैस. सो 1857 में क्लॉशियस ने गैसेस की जनरल प्रॉपर्टीज और गैस लॉज को थ्योरेटिकली एक्सप्लेन करने के लिए एक थ्योरी पुट फॉरवर्ड की, एक थ्योरी दी, एंड दैट थ्योरी इज नोन एज काइनेटिक मॉलिकुलर थ्योरी ऑफ गैस. नाउ देयर आर वेरियस पोस्टुलेट्स ऑफ द काइनेटिक मॉलिकुलर थ्योरी ऑफ गैस एंड वी हैव टू स्टडी दोज पोस्टुलेट्स. हमने उन पोस्टुलेट्स को पढ़ना है एंड आई हैव रिटन द की पॉइंट्स ऑफ दोज पोस्टुलेट्स. आई हैव रिटन द की पॉइंट. नाउ इफ वी मूव टू द फर्स्ट पॉइंट, द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज एवरी गैस इज मेड अप ऑफ अ लार्ज नंबर ऑफ एक्सट्रीमली स्मॉल पार्टिकल्स कॉल्ड मॉलिक्यूल्स. वट एवर गैस यू विल टेक, वेदर नाइट्रोजन, हाइड्रोजन, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, मीथेन, फॉस्जीन, वट एवर गैस यू टेक, all the gases are made up of large number of extremely small particles which are known as molecules. This is the key point, but the explanation in this point is that if we talk about the molecules of a single gas, of a gas, then all the molecules of a gas are identical in mass and size, but the molecules of different gas are different in mass and size. This thing you have to know. Clear? So the key point is that every gas, सारी की सारी gas किससे बनी है? Large number of extremely small particles, जिनको क्या नाम दिया गया? Molecules. It means according to kinetic molecular theory of gases, gas is made up of molecules. Clear? And second thing, kinetic molecular theory of gas ने क्या कहा? That all the molecules of a gas identical in mass and size, but the molecules of different gas are different in mass and size. First point clear? Now, the second point is, volume of a molecule is negligible as compared to the total volume of gas. Clear? It means, एक मॉलिक्यूल का जो वॉल्यूम होगा, वो टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ द गैस के कंपेयर में हम क्या मानेंगे? नेग्लिजिबल. नाउ व्हाई इट इज सो? Because of very large intermolecular space present between the molecules of the gas. The molecules of the gas are separated from each other with a very large difference, as a result of which the volume of molecule is considered as a negligible volume as compared to the total volume of the gas. Clear beta? एक कंटेनर में जब हम वॉल्यूम को फिल करेंगे तो जो गैस होगी वो बहुत दूर दूर आपकी प्रेजेंट होगी. सो बिकॉज ऑफ द वेरी लार्ज इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस, एक जो आपका गैस का वॉल्यूम है, बिकॉज इट इज वेरी स्मॉल पार्टिकल, सो एक मॉलिक्यूल का जो वॉल्यूम है वो ओवरऑल गैस के वॉल्यूम के कंपैरिजन में बहुत ही कम होगा, एंड दैट वी कैन निगलेक्ट. सो द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस इज द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ अ गैस आर सेपरेटेड बाय वेरी लार्ज इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस. सेकेंड थिंग इज क्लियर. Now third, the force of attraction or repulsion between molecules is negligible. Now, in second point, we have told that the intermolecular space present between the gas molecule is very large. And if the molecules are very far away from each other, then there is very, very, very little either force of attraction or repulsion occur between them. जब मॉलिक्यूल एक दूसरे से बहुत दूर होंगे तो उनके बीच में जो फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन या फोर्स ऑफ रिपल्शन लग रहा है वो वैल्यू बहुत ही मिनिमम होगी, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू काइनेटिक मॉलिक्यूलर थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेस वी कैन निगलेक्ट दैट वैल्यू. हम उस वैल्यू को क्या कर सकते हैं? निगलेक्ट. सो बिकॉज ऑफ वेरी लार्ज इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस प्रेजेंट बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ द गैस, द फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन और द फोर्स ऑफ रिपल्शन विच अगर बिटवीन देम इज वेरी वेरी लेस, विच वी कैन निगलेक्ट. सो दिस इज आवर थर्ड पॉइंट. सो द रीजन बिहाइंड सेकेंड एंड थर्ड पॉइंट इज सेम. the reason behind second point and third point is same, and that is the intermolecular space. Intermolecular space is very large. Clear, beta? Now, the fourth one. According to kinetic molecular theory of gases, the force of gravitation is also supposed to be negligible. Clear? Kinetic molecular theory of gas ke according, the force of gravitation exerted on the gaseous molecule. गैशियस मॉलिक्यूल पे जो फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन लग रहा है उसको भी क्या माना, ऑलमोस्ट नेग्लिजिबल. क्लियर? दिस इज आवर फोर्थ पॉइंट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, मॉलिक्यूल्स आर सपोज्ड टू मूव कॉन्टिन्यूसली इन द वेसल. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट हमारा क्या है, मॉलिक्यूल्स जो हैं उनको ये माना गया कि वो कॉन्टिन्यूस मूवमेंट में है, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ द कॉन्टिन्यूस मूवमेंट द फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन इज सपोज्ड टू बी नेग्लिजिबल. Clear? So, molecules are supposed to move continuously in the vessel, and while moving, they are colliding with each other as well as with the vessel in which they are present. Jis vessel mein humne gas ko put kiya hai, while moving, these gas molecules are colliding with each other because there is a random motion. Ek random motion ho raha hai, koi specific motion nahi hai. So, jab ye move kar rahe hain, तो ये एक दूसरे से भी कोलाइड कर रहे हैं और साथ ही साथ वेसल्स की वॉल से भी कोलाइड कर रहे हैं. सो व्हाट इज आवर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट मॉलिक्यूल्स आर सपोज्ड टू मूव कॉन्टिन्यूसली इन द वेसल, व्हाइल मूविंग दे आर कोलाइडिंग विद ईच अदर एज वेल एज विद द वॉल्स ऑफ द वेसल्स. जो वेसल्स है उसकी वॉल्स के साथ भी वो क्या कर रहे हैं, कोलाइड कर रहे हैं. दिस थिंग क्लियर? नाउ next is the pressure exerted on the walls, means the pressure exerted on the vessel. अब जो vessel में जो pressure आ रहा है फिर वो आ कहां से रहा है? So the pressure exerted on the walls due to the bombardment of the molecules of the gas. In previous point what we have studied, that molecules are in continuous motion, they are colliding with each other as well as with the walls of the vessels. When they collide the walls of the vessel, when they bombard with the walls of the vessel, they exert a pressure. So, the pressure exerted on the walls, जो pressure exert हो रहा है vessel की wall पे, वो किस वजह से हो रहा है? Because of the collision of the molecules on the walls of the vessels. Vessels पे जब वो टकरा रहे हैं, तब वहां पे क्या create हो रहा है? Pressure. So, the total pressure of the gas is due to the bombardment of the gaseous molecules on the walls of the container. This point is also clear? Okay. Now, the next point is, in kinetic molecular theory, it is supposed that the molecules are perfectly elastic hard sphere. क्या माना गया kinetic molecular theory of gases में? कि जो हमारे molecules हैं, molecules हमारे perfectly elastic hard sphere. And why it is so? Because if a body is a perfectly elastic hard sphere, then if the body collide with any substance, or if a body strike with any substance, then there will be no energy loss. अगर कोई body perfectly elastic hard sphere होती है, तो जब वो किसी other body से टकराती है, तो वहाँ पे कोई भी energy का loss नहीं होता है. Yes, there is a transfer of electron energy from one molecule to another molecule, but there is no loss of energy. So, yahi kinetic molecular theory of gas ne bhi kaha that it's supposed that the molecules are perfectly elastic hard sphere, and because they are perfectly elastic hard sphere, so while bombarding, they are not losing energy. Yes, they are releasing the energy from one molecule to another molecule. This they are doing, but they are not losing the energy at all. Energy wo release, energy wo lose nahi karenge. And because, kyun nahi karenge? Kyunki they are perfectly elastic hard sphere. So, kinetic molecular theory of gas supposed that the molecules of a gases are perfectly elastic, hard sphere, and because of this reason, they'll not lose the energy. Yes, they'll transform the energy from one molecule to another molecule. This point is clear, beta? Okay. Now we'll move to our last point, that because every molecule is moving, and every molecule is moving with different velocity, and we know that when we are in motion, right now I am in a standing position, so my kinetic energy is zero. Now I am moving, so I have a kinetic energy in me. So whenever a body is in motion, it means kinetic energy is there in that body. So because the gas molecules are also moving, so they have kinetic energy. But different molecules are moving with different velocity, so different molecules have different kinetic energy. But if we calculate the average kinetic energy of the molecule of the gas, means if we calculate the average kinetic energy, then the average kinetic energy of the molecules of a gas is directly proportional to absolute temperature. Means with increase in the temperature, average kinetic energy of a of the molecules of a gas increases. I am not saying that with increase in temperature the kinetic energy of a particular molecule increases. मैं ये नहीं कह रही हूँ कि if suppose Avogadro number of molecules are present in a vessel, so by increasing temperature the kinetic energy of all the molecules increases. ये मैं नहीं कह रही हूँ. Clear? But the average kinetic energy of the molecules of the gas, yes, it is increases. Average kinetic energy increase hogi, but it is not necessary that har molecule ki kinetic energy increase ho. Ho sakta hai, due to the increase in the temperature, one of the molecule become less energy, the other molecule have higher energy. But the average kinetic energy, अगर हम average kinetic energy लेंगे, so average kinetic energy हमारी क्या होगी? Increase होगी with increase in the temperature. So these are the various postulates of the kinetic molecular theory of gases. So I hope you don't have any problem in this postulates of the kinetic molecular theory of gases. So from the various postulates of the kinetic molecular theory of gases, an equation can be derived which is known as kinetic gas equation. Jitne bhi humne assumptions padhe, jitne bhi humne postulates padhe, on the basis of those postulates, a mathematical expression can be derived, a mathematical equation can be derived which is known as kinetic gas equation. So you don't have to study the derivation, but the kinetic gas equation you have to know. And the kinetic gas equation is PV equals to 1 by 3 mnu square. PV equals to 1 by 3 mnu square. This is the kinetic gas equation, where P is the pressure of the gas, V is the volume of the gas, m is the mass of a molecule, mass of a single molecule of a gas, n is the number of the molecules of the gas in volume V. Clear? And u is the root mean square speed. Clear? So P hamara kya hai? Pressure of the gas. V hamara kya hai? Volume of the gas. M hamara kya hai? Mass of a single molecule of a gas. N is the number of the molecules which are present in volume V. V में कितने हमारे number of molecules of gas present है वो, और U हमारा क्या है? Root mean square velocity, speed, root mean square speed. Clear this thing? And this is a kinetic gas equation. Now, there is a very interesting thing about the kinetic gas equation, that through kinetic gas equation, we can able to deduct the Boyle's law as well as the Charles law. हम Boyle's law और Charles law को क्या कर सकते हैं? Deduct with the help of this kinetic gas equation. So first we'll deduct deduction of Boyle's law through the kinetic gas equation. And kinetic gas equation किस पे based है? Kinetic molecular theory of gases. Clear? I have told you that Clausius discover this theory in order to explain the gas laws theoretically. Clear? So, deduction of Boyle's law. Now, this m is the mass of the molecule, mass of the single molecule, and n is the total number of the molecules, total number of the molecule. Let n be 1 mole. If n be 1 mole, then it contains Avogadro number of molecule, Avogadro number of molecules. हम n को क्या मान ले रहे हैं? हम n को 1 मोल मान रहे हैं. अगर n 1 मोल है तो उसमें एवोगैड्रो नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स होंगे, एंड एवोगैड्रो नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय मास इन 1 मॉलिक्यूल, दैट इज इक्वल टू द मोलर मास, दैट इज इक्वल टू मोलर मास. इट मींस स्मॉल m इनटू n इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल n. क्लियर? सो इफ आई पुट हियर इट्स pv इक्वल टू 1/3 कैपिटल m u स्क्वायर. क्लियर? नाउ I divide and multiply this side by 2. 2 divided by 2. अगर मैं ऐसा करूंगी तो कोई भी चेंज नहीं होगा, the equation remain as such. Now if I rearrange the equation, PV equals to 2/3 into 1/2 mu square. So मैंने simply rearrange किया, equation अभी भी वही है. अगर मैं 2 और 2 को cancel करूंगी, the equation remains same. Clear? Now half mv mu square. U is speed or velocity. Now, if I talk about kinetic energy, it is half mv square. So, in place of this, I can write kinetic energy. PV is equals to 2/3 into kinetic energy. Clear? And if I talk about one postulate of the kinetic molecular theory of gas, according to that postulate, kinetic energy is directly proportional to absolute temperature. It means kinetic energy equals to kT, where K is the proportionality constant. In place of kinetic energy, I can write this also, that is 2/3 into kT. Clear? So my equation becomes PV equals to 2/3 into kT. Now 2/3 is a constant quantity. Ye hamesha constant rahegi. K is a constant. Now if I kept temperature constant, if I keep the temperature constant, then PV comes constant. And this is the Boyle's law. This is the Boyle's law that PV equals to constant. So 2/3 constant hai, K constant hai. Agar main temperature ko constant rakhti hu, means at constant temperature, the PV becomes constant. Means PV is equals to constant. And this is Boyle's. Ye hamara Boyle's law. Clear? This one is our Boyle's law. Clear the? Now, deduction of Charles law. Deduction of Charles law. So, here we get PV equals to 2/3 kT. This we get. Now, if I keep T here and P here. T here and P here. Clear? 2/3 constant here. K constant hai. At constant pressure, V upon T becomes constant, and that is Charles law. Clear? Matlab agar main pressure constant rakhti hu, so this overall quantity becomes constant. So it becomes V/T equals to constant. And this is our Charles law. Ye hamara kya hai? Charles law. So in this way, we can deduct Boyle's law and Charles law from the kinetic equation, kinetic gas equation. और काइनेटिक गैस इक्वेशन हमने कहां से डिराइव की है? फ्रॉम द पोस्टुलेट्स, वेरियस पोस्टुलेट्स ऑफ द काइनेटिक मॉलिक्यूलर थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेस. क्लियर? आई थिंक इट इज क्लियर. सो इन दिस वीडियो वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द पोस्टुलेट्स. इफ द पोस्टुलेट्स आर नॉट क्लियर टू यू, देन रिवाइंड द वीडियो एंड सी द पोस्टुलेट्स अगेन, वॉच द पोस्टुलेट्स अगेन, एंड हाउ वी डिटेक्ट द बॉयल्स लॉ एंड द चार्ल्स लॉ थ्रू द काइनेटिक गैस इक्वेशन. So that's all for today, students. I'll see you in my next video.